This is Pete with Life Invest, and today we are here to discuss about the Estonian real estate market in 2020. If you are more interested in investing in Estonia and earning rental income over here, then check out our website, lifeinvest.eu. So let's get right to it. What's been happening then in Estonian real estate market in year 2020? Since spring, obviously the crazy times came up on us, and the activity in the real estate market took a massive hit as well. There wasn't a lot of deals happening in the spring, but when summer came, it recovered surprisingly well, and by autumn, the activity in the market was basically back on the levels that were there last year. Since then, the prices have been even rising. The signals actually have been mixed on the market. The second-hand flats and the new developments, the balance between them has been off a little bit. There has been less deals happening with the second round flats than with the new developments, and due to that the average price has been pushed up a little bit. Talking about mixed feelings on the market, we have to talk about the stock of new development apartments. This time last year there was around 250 flats up for grabs, but at the moment there is around 500 flats, so this number has doubled. But we can see that the market is actually quite active. There was more sales done in September than at the same time last year. Having my boots on the ground and being in the business, I can see from my own portfolio that there is actually a lot of people on the market right now, and stuff is selling actually quite well. Also, the interest rates have remained on similar level. Estonian Bank has said that the average interest rate in Estonia is 2.5%, which is quite high compared to the other EU nations. But the banks, they have been a little bit more cautious. You can tell that the hospitality sector people are not getting loans at the moment. And the banks are looking more into people's backgrounds before they are actually making the decision. What we can see though is that the sales processes are taking a little bit longer than they used to, and the power is slowly going over to the cash buyer, so there's more possibilities on the market to push the price down a little bit for the investors. Talking about the rental market, then that really took a big hit in the spring months. There was less foreign students coming in, there was less foreign workers coming in, and even local people, they were more staying put than moving into Tallinn. That being said, the Airbnb flats in the city center, lots of them, actually the number was around 700 over 2 month period in the spring months. Over several hundred of them, they came on the long-term market, and that really affected the prices. It pushed the prices down, and for the summer months, it was a struggle to find tenants and get one in with a decent price. As we know, the most important thing in real estate is location, and we can also see that in the current state that well-located property is still wanted, and there's many newly built buildings in very hot locations over here that people are always willing to buy, and these places are still going very well. We can see from our portfolio at the moment that well-located and newly built buildings are performing still well. Their rent has stayed stable, and their overall value also as well. And in the end of the day, it's always coming down to the location itself. If the location is wanted and it's popular in the local people, then these places are still going as usual. If you learned anything in this video, guys, then like and subscribe. And if you want to learn more about investing in Estonia, then download our blueprint, Operation Silicon Valley EU. You can find the link in the description down below. Thanks again, guys, and see you soon.